Hi friends, welcome to my channel Industrial CAD Tutorials. Want to watch my videos? Subscribe my channel. Have to subscribe my channel to click on the subscribe button. Want to give suggestions about my videos? For more information through mails, by simply click on show more. In this video, I'm going to explain how to draw a 3D model bend of 90 degree long radius elbow. Or bend in AutoCAD. Go on to the mechanical design and select the part design, and the new part design dialog box will appear. On the enter on the new part name, enter the part name. I'm giving 90 degree bend or elbow. This is a 3D. I'm giving 3D, and on the enable hybrid design and create geometrical set both and click on OK. And go on to the XY plane of the sketcher workbench. Go on to select the XY plane and select the sketcher. This is a sketcher. In this sketcher workbench, how to develop the model, and go on to the 3D model and create the 3D model by using the 3D model workbench in part design. First of all, open the previous drawing of the 2D elbow drawing, already explained in previous tutorial. You want to download the file, click on the description link. The download file is available. All the download files are available. These are the AutoCAD drawing is opening. I want to explain the what are the toolbars. This is the user selection toolbar and the sketch tools and the profile toolbar. The profile toolbar is used to make a sketch of any of the circles or rectangles. This is the 3D workbench and the 2D workbench have different types of toolbars to develop a model. Profile, operation toolbars. In operation toolbar, general requirements are fillet, chamfer. These are then workbench has exit workbench and the constraint to give the dimensions, and view toolbar, different types of isometric view, left right view. These are the different types of views, and these are the shades with edges. After developing the 3D model, these shades of edges are very important to see the model in 3D. It means to change the visual styles of the 3D model. This is the XY plane. It has three planes: XY plane, YZ plane and ZX plane. Three planes are there. You want to develop any of the plane as your wish. The any of the 3D model has one of the process to maintain the any of the model in process, design in process. These are the views in exit workbench. This is the 3D workbench toolbar. These are the sketch based features and dust separate features. Why I am this highlighting these toolbars now I am using to develop a 3D model. These are the general toolbars in CATIA software to develop a 3D model. See, the AutoCAD drawing is open. This is the previous tutorial drawing of the elbow, 90 degrees long radius elbow. Already given the dimensions, all the dimensions. The radius is 114.3 and the OD 88.9, and the distance in between the end to the center to the end 114.3 and 114.3, and the thickness of the elbow is bend is 5.5 as per the standard requirement of the pipe. Both of the thickness will same as per standard. This is a schedule 40 of 3 inch pipe elbow bend. All the dimensions are given and 2D sketch is also there. To download the file, click on the description link. The download file is available. Next, draw a circle on the center, on the profile toolbar, on the sketcher workbench, and constrain the dimension to 114.3. Give it as radius. The radius is 114.3. I'm giving 114.3 radius and click on OK. The radius of the circle is created. The circle radius is 114.3 and draw a center at two ends of the circle. The vertical line and the horizontal line, half of the part and the quarter part is required. 1/4 part is required and remaining part to remove by using the quick trim on the operation. Select on the this 1/4 part is required on the total circle. Take the total circles of 1/4 part and draw and check the dimensions is 114.3 and the distance is same. The vertical and horizontal line both are in 114.3 as per the radius given. 114.3 is the actual radius. giving, and delete the two lines, two vertical lines of the, for reference only I'm taking the delete the two lines. This circle is first, the circle is created nothing but a small arc of 114.3 radius. This is the 114.3 C, this is 114.3, already explained in previous tutorial. The 90 degrees elbow radius is 114.3, the center reference radius line. This is the center reference radius line, this is a 114.3. Next, go on to the exit workbench. Exit workbench, the circle is created like this. The two endpoints are created. Already it has the two endpoints. On the two endpoints, to create a two planes to develop a bend of the pipe as per the remove the object and to form a required pipe as per the sweep. This is a sweep curve. This is not in a straight cylinder, it is in a curve type cylinder I have to form a bend, and click on the point and select the point and go and select the plane on the reference plane and select the point and select the reference plane element. The plane definition, one of the definition tool is there, click on that. Simply select the point and select the plane, and the dialog, reference element dialogs will appears. The plane definition dialog box will appear. In this plane tab, select the plane tabs normal to curve, and select the curve of the sketch. This is the curve I am selecting. After select the point, then the one of the plane is created on the endpoint of the curve, and click on preview and click on OK. The plane is created. On that plane, we have to create a circle to form a solid object of the elbow. See, the plane is created at the same endpoint. Also create this same like that only, one of the plane, select the point and go on to the reference element toolbar and select the plane. The third one is plane, and select the third definition, select the plane, and plane definition dialog which appears. Simply select the plane type normal to curve, and select the curve. The curve and sketch 3 is the curve is showing, and click on OK. The plane, two planes are created under two of the endpoints. On the two on the endpoints, draw a two circles of the same diameter and to form a solid object of the elbow, and draw a circle on outside any of the plane you select by using onto the sketcher workbench. Go on to the sketcher workbench and draw a circle. The circle diameter is nothing but the outer diameter I am taking. The outer diameter is 88.90. See in the AutoCAD drawing, the diameter I am giving. Give the diameter 88.90 and click on OK. The diameter is created. I want to make the circle to intersect to the plane. Select the circles, two circle endpoints by using control. Select the first circle, first point on the plane, and the midpoint, and then select the midpoint of the circle. Both are selected by using control. Simply, the diameter is 88.90. The circle is not showing. Once again, if the circle is not showing, once again draw the circle or any of the problem occurs. Select the endpoint of the circle by using control key and press on control, and press on control center of the plane. One point is there, and constant definition toolbar will upset, and click on coincidence and click on OK. The circle will coincidence to the and end point of the middle point of the plane. See, go on to the exit workbench, then you observe the circle is exactly form on the center point of the plane. Then go on to the another plane, draw a same like that only, draw a circle of radius 88.90 of diameter of the pipe is 88.90. I'm taking 88.90. The diameter of the pipe is 88.90 and the thickness is 5.49. First consider the 88.9 outer diameter and select the two points by using control and coincidence and click on OK. The coincidence is created. Simply it will go onto the center point of the plane. Simply the two points are intersected, the two circles are created on the two planes. And next, go on to the multi-section solids on the sketch based feature. Select the first circle and select the second circles. Both the directions will not same, then the sweep will not form. Check the directions of the points, the sweep will form. It's carefully the solid model is created by using these two planes on the normal to curve. I want to develop a hole, nothing but it is look like a pipe. This is the solid material. First I want to same create a plane, go on to the plane, any of the plane, two planes, and select the plane and draw a circle same like that only, and coincidence with the constraint definition toolbar by using constraint, and draw the internal diameter. Check the internal diameter. The internal diameter is 77.90. check the dimension once. This is 77 point after remaining thickness 5.49, 77.90 it's showing. The internal diameter of the pipe is 77.90, and draw a and draw a circle of 77.90 and check the constraint and edit the by using constraint. 77.90 circle is created, and select the center point and select the center point of the plane and go into the constraint definition. Dialog box will appear and the constraint, click on the constraint tool, the constraint, click on coincidence and click on OK. The circle is created, 77.90, same as on the other plane. Create a same of the circle of 77.90 dimension and constraint to its 77.90 mm. All dimensions are mm, and select the plane and go on to the sketcher. The plane is highlighted, then draw a circle of the circle on the plane. It is not showing the plane, and diameter is 77.90 same, and select the center point by using control key. Select the point and color the constraint definition. Click on constraints and click on OK. The circle is, two circles are created as same as the previous process. In that I am created a multi-section solids. In this I am using multi-removal section solids. To remove the material I am using the second one is there, the multi-section solid. On right side on the icon is there, this is the removal multi-section solids, and click on that removal multi-section solids tool. The removal multi-section solids dialog box appears, definition dialog box will appear, and click on the two sketches what you drawn in the before. You already before another two planes. Select the first sketch and select the second sketch. The two sketches are selected. It is showing sketch 7 and sketch 6, and the directions will not same. Then object is not created. See, the sweep creation is not created. The directions are not good. Then only it is not. Drawing is not completed. Select the two circles and select the directions in the same direction, then click on preview and click on OK. See, the 90 degrees elbow is created. This is the 90 degree elbow bend in 3D model by using CATIA. This is the not only I'm this is the elbow bend. This is the one of the basic tutorial how to sweep the material by using multi-section solids and the removal multi-section solids. Follow my next videos also explaining some different techniques and different features in CATIA. I want to give the chamfer definition. I want to give the bevel to the bevel is nothing but I am giving the chamfer to 5 mm by selecting the circle. Because why I am giving the chamfer, this is the welding point to connect any of the pipe to the elbow pipe. The chamfer definition will required, must and should required to weld the material in between to join the two pipes. The bevel is required. This is the bevel. This is the 5 mm thickness, 5.49. I am giving 5 mm chamfer, and 0.49 is there on the side face. See, the 0.49 is there on the face. It will connect to the two pipes. It will help you. This is the example. This is the model of the 3D model elbow bend. And different types of views are there: top view, left view, right view, and isometric views. These are the shades. See the shades, what type of shades you want. Select the shades. Different types of shades are there. To see on different shades, it will look like a original model, not on the manufacturing type model. This is the elbow, small elbow of 90 degree of long radius elbow. This is the construction of elbow in CATIA to make a 3D model. All the two models are explained clearly. To download the files, go on to the description link. The download files are available. This is the wireframe, and select the wireframe, it will show like this. All the sweep lines will showing how the object will form before the construction. It will show all the shades, and click on the multiple view option. This in multiple view, so many four types of views are you can observe. These are the four tab. First one is the isometric view, and the front view, and the top view, left view, and the right view. These are the four views. Then select on the individual. Any of the view is highlighted to zoom it individually. See, by using multiple view, you can understand the total any of the 3D model drawing. The views are very important to know any of the drawing, to any of to draw a model or any of to design a model in any of the software. Thanks for watching my video. Do like, share, comment, and subscribe. Do you want more videos? Please click on subscribe button.